doing some in my chest, but that's mainly because I'm putting on chest muscle. And for guys, like, this is really tough to lose fat in. It's sort of like one of the last things that seems to go down for guys in the lower stomach. Lost like 4 inches on my belly, and, you know, my weight was 361, now it's at 341, which is a 2 pound loss for the week, which is right on target. So there's not much to report as far as preparing for tough mudder is concerned. I've been kind of dropping weight, I've played a muscle, working harder in the gym. Something I wanted to talk about was setbacks. Not to go into too much detail with today, somebody that I grew up with said some really mean things to me. A lot of them were true with things I did before, you know, and when you talk about changing your life or moving on to do something better or anything like that, there's always those people that are going to hold on to what you've done before. And anybody who knows me or has known me for any extended period of time knows that I wasn't always a good person. I was selfish and lied, and I was out for me. I lied to a lot of people about a lot of things that were stupid, and I don't know why I did it, but I swear I have been trying to be better. But this, you know, it just, this person was really important to me, and it was, you know, it seems like no matter how much change you make in your life, no matter what you try to do, it's never good enough. So I was faced with the decision, what do I do? Do I go and buy some soda and pizza and eat my sorrows, or do I try to do something better and to motivate me to do more work or less work, whatever, you know? And I decided that I was going to go burn it off at the gym, so I did. Today I did full body, up and down, and legs, arms, chest, shoulders, back, glutes, everything. And I did an hour on the treadmill. I burned about, estimate for around 1,800 calories in about two and a half hours. Now, that's not to say that you guys have to put in that much exercise. I kind of needed to today. I needed time by myself, just working out and sort through everything mentally. So a couple of things I'm noticing. Changes, I think, like my skin is better, you know, I'm not as blotchy and stuff like that. My elbows aren't as dry without me having moisturizer. My elbows aren't dry at all, and that has to do with the water that I'm drinking and stuff. So yeah, as far as like progress goes with some mudder, you know, I'm making progress that I wanted to. I'm, you know, doing everything that I wanted to do, but we had pizza the other day for our cheat meal, but like I am realizing that, you know, I'm 35 now, there's just food I can't eat anymore, and I think dairy is just one of those foods. I just can't do it. Even for cheat meals. I think my next thing will probably be like a steak or something. What else? This week, to up my my exercising a little bit and get a little higher intensity. Do my best to lower my rest times and up my reps on the weights. My exercise has been on point. I've been pretty active. Motivation is something that I think a lot of people struggle with, especially when it comes to eating right. Everybody thinks like you lose motivation to work out, but I think you lose more motivation to eat right. I think that's kind of where the challenge comes into play, as far as like loss of motivation, because it's so easy, you eat so much more often than you work out, and it is so easy to walk in the kitchen and just be like, oh, I just want some fucking ice cream, or I want something where I don't have to cook, or you just have to keep thinking about where you're going, what you want to do, why you're doing it. You know, the why is so important. For me, it's to be healthy so I can take care of my kids better. And obviously I want to be a tough mother. But some people, you know, I'm not saying this is for everybody, but I think that if you have a superficial reason, like you want a six pack, or you want to wear a bathing suit or something like that, like something kind of dumb, it's not going to last. Like, even if you lose that weight, once you know, some people equate looking good to finding love, like, you lose that weight and you realize that, oh wow, you know, more people are noticing you, but nothing's changed. They give up and they go back to where they were. So I think a lot of the boils down to like what brought you to start your journey, especially. And you know, for me, it has nothing to do with walking around with a shirt on or anything like that. I mean, for me, it 100% is to be stronger and to, you know, to be able to be alive. You know, through the bad stuff. Eating has become a big problem. Fucking hate it. It is like the worst part of my day is eating food. I cannot stand it. And it's not like, oh, I hate the food I eat. It's not that. It's I eat so much of it. You know, like, I'm eating 2 pounds of chicken a day. Like, 4 cups of broccoli. 3 cups of rice. And then in the morning I have to have like, you know, like fiber cereal with, that's because I have to hit my fiber count, I have to hit my protein count, I have to hit my, you know, make sure I'm under my sodium count. And God, it's fucking hard. So hard. But, alright guys, well, it's late. That's all I got for this week. If any of you are doing a similar thing, just don't lose hope. And like I said, it messed me up today, but there's always a better choice. There's always the right choice and the wrong choice, no matter how you slice it. So I will talk to you guys in another week. This week I'm hoping to drop a little bit more than 2 pounds, but